How many people in the room know someone that's committed suicide? I'd like you to raise your hand with me if you do, but keep your hand up. And now look around the room with your hand up. Suicide is a tragedy. 50% of us in America know someone that's committed it. And like all tragedies, it's a call for action. Today, I'd like to tell you a story about the loss of two of my friends to suicide and how that was a starting point for a platform that now brings people together over lunch. When I first started my PhD at MIT about 5 years ago, I had heard the statistics about campus suicides. But you know, the interesting thing about statistics are that it's just that, they're just statistics. They don't mean anything until they touch you in a personal way. So 2 years into my PhD, approximately, a friend of mine made the unfortunate decision to take his own life. And I remember when I first heard the news, I was really shocked by it. I thought, why would somebody who is getting this prestigious degree, he's so close to graduation, and he has his whole life in front of him, make a decision to end it all? Why? But then, you know, that feeling of shock made a quick change when I learned that if he had been found just a few minutes sooner, he could have been resuscitated and brought back. He might be here in the audience today, sitting with you. I started to ask myself, what part did I play in this or not play in this? Maybe if I had, when I passed him in the hallway earlier that week, said a couple words or invited him out for dinner, maybe the course of destiny would have been different. Maybe I could have been that one person that altered his destiny. Suicide is a tragedy, and like all tragedies, we learn to accept it as time goes on. And as I was coming to terms with the loss of this first friend, I was hit by the loss of another. And this time it was much closer to home. This time it was a childhood friend, someone I knew for 15 years. I grew up with this person, riding bikes down the street, digging for fossils in desert lots, all the things that kids do. And you know, well, at least in New Mexico. Did anybody hear the news about the fossil that was found? Yeah. In all seriousness, though, when this friend of mine made the decision to take her life, that half-life on the shock to regret, it was very, very quick to just become a sensation of regret. I asked myself, you know, in the time that we had both kind of moved away and started to live our own lives and had drifted apart, maybe I played a role in that. Maybe if I would have been in better touch, destiny would have turned out different. Maybe I did have some role to play in this, because one person really can change destiny. And this set of back-to-back suicides really did have an impact on me. It does till today. I started wondering, how as a society did we get to a point where suicide is the second leading cause of death among young people? And why does year after year the number and the incidents continue to rise? I'm not going to sit here and pretend I know the answer to that question. I'm not educated enough, or I don't research this enough to give you a complete answer. What I can tell you, though, is that social isolation is part of the problem. It's really unprecedented, isn't it? You know, this device that sits in our pocket, or whatever version of this that sits in your pockets, it's facilitated communication that's historically unprecedented. You can pick up your telephone and speak to another person on the other side of the planet, live, and almost for free in all cases. But somehow, in the increasing of the bandwidth of communication, there's this growing sense that we've sacrificed something about what communication was supposed to facilitate in the first place, which was that genuine connection with the other person. The quantity and the quality has somehow become unbalanced. You know, an average person spends about 2 hours a day on social media, but half of us eat our lunch alone on any given day. It's a paradox. I'm guilty of going and crawling LinkedIn, saying, oh, I'm going to find that next connection. It's going to really revolutionize my career. But then I don't know anyone who works in my floor of my workplace. It's crazy, isn't it? It's really crazy. So, you know, I was thinking about this paradox. And I decided to confide in a friend of mine and a colleague, Tuka Al-Hanai, who's actually here in the audience today. And Tuka said to me, well, this is great that you found out all these great statistics, but again, it's just statistics. What are you going to do about it? And what we did about it over the next 2 years was a platform called Connect. The idea of Connect is very, very simple. You tell us who you are, when you're free, what you like to eat, and we tell you who to meet, when to meet, and where. The point of Connect was to not increase your face-to-screen time, increase your face-to-face time with other people. All the interactions are one-on-one, they're platonic, they're in-person, and if you're at a university campus, we even pay for your lunch, so you can quote me on this, there is actually such a thing as a free lunch. Connect is not intended to be the next Facebook. It is not currently the next Facebook. There are no profile pictures. There's no chat. There's no advertisements. You're not going to know if the person you meet wears a headscarf, how old they are, or what their racial background is. Not until you meet them, one-on-one, in person, and face-to-face. Over the last couple years, Connect has facilitated 7,000 connections both in the Boston area and outside. And it's really blown my mind. I didn't expect when we built this that this would have happened. 90% of the users enjoy their experience, and 50% of the users have made a lasting friend. Do you remember what I said earlier, though? 50% of us eat lunch alone. What a lucky coincidence that is, right? It was something beautiful when we first saw that. But again, what am I doing? I'm just quoting statistics, right? It doesn't mean anything until it touches you personally. And just 2 months ago, the outcome of all this work did touch me personally. When just one guy who had used the platform completely unprovoked sent me and Tuka a very simple email. He just said, hi there, I want to say that this platform was responsible for some of my best memories at MIT. Thank you. And I have to say, as somebody who is fortunate to attend an institution that really has accelerated my own academic progress, that email felt better than many of the things I've ever done at MIT as an academic. Even the growth of Connect is the story of how one person chose to make a difference. Initially, it was just going to be a platform that sat at MIT, and it did good things at MIT, and we were going to leave it like that. But then another member of the audience who's here today, Hedya from the University of Toledo, decided she wanted to send an email and said, hey, this would be great at my school. And just like that, destiny was altered. And we've since configured Connect so that now anyone can email us and say, I want this at my school. And we can, at the turn of a key, launch it. And if you're one of those people, I can't wait to hear from you. The future of Connect is not just something to be contained within the walls of academia. We believe that it can solve problems of social isolation among the elderly, or at least play a part in that process. And we think that the issue I brought up about workplaces, you don't know anyone who works in your office space, it could play a part in solving that problem too. But I want to make something very clear. Connect, it's not a panacea. It's not going to solve every problem that has to do with our lack of connectedness. What it is it's one piece in a mosaic of things that we can do to be better connected as people. Another one of those things that we can do is something that I'm going to ask every single one of you in the audience to do today. Keep your heart and your mind open today, here, at the TEDx session, to the opportunity of making a new friend. Because you really never know. You could be that one person that changes someone's destiny, or you could meet that one person that changes yours. Thank you.